Oi oi, what's your blokes and blokettes? In this video, this one, I'm going to do a cabin air filter change on her. I haven't done that since I've got it, and I'm going to do an oil... an oil filter change on her too. So, come along for the ride, let's roll the tape, and I'll see you the other side. Toodle pip!
Watcher, blokes and blokettes, you're through to Oily Works. I'm the Baldy Brit Bloke, and this is my YouTube channel. Oi oi!
Here she is. She is a good looking wagoon, isn't she? All right, the air filter for the cabin is in here, in these ones. I've never done the air filter in here, so I'm sure the filter needs doing. I've done about 20,000 kilometers on her. Let's tackle this right away. So I believe we just need to squeeze the two sides. There we go. That's quite easy, isn't it? Now, where are we? Come on, baby. Push the two side clips in. Bit tight, isn't it? Oh. Ooh, a lot of mouse poo in there, or maybe it's chipmunk poo. Yeah, it definitely needs doing. It's a mess. Okay. When you put the filter in, these two flanges need to tuck into these on either side. Make sure to get the arrow the right way up. Sweet! There we go. Slide her back in and cabin filter done. Sweet! With Audrey being a Japanese import, it can be a bit of a hassle getting parts for her. Thankfully, there's a few companies online that you can cross-reference parts on. So I just type in RB1, which is the platform for this particular Honda Odyssey in Japan, and then I put cabin air filter and it brings it up straight away. A lot of the parts on this particular model cross-reference with Acura models, later year Acura models. This is a 2005, and a lot of the parts on it are compatible with 2009 Acura models, and it varies model to model. Don't despair if you've got a Japanese import. I'm going to drop the name of the website that I use right here, so check them out. They don't just do Honda, they do Toyota and a bunch of other Japanese import makes as well. When I lived in England, it was quite easy for me to, or for us to go and get parts. We'd just go into Toyota. Well, I had a Toyota, a Japanese import Toyota, and I would just go into the Toyota dealership and give them the VIN number, and they can order all of the parts from Japan, and it would take 2 or 3 weeks to get the stuff air freighted over. And it was quite reasonably priced as well, because they were doing it for a lot of other people. So the shipments would come all at once. And I'm sure you could do the same for Honda and Nissan and other Japanese domestic market mates in UK and possibly even Europe, but you can't do that here. Feel free to use that website to cross-reference your parts. These parts I got from the local auto supply store, but you can probably get them from Canadian Tire as well. Okay, don't despair. We will get through this together with Japanese imports. We gotta love them, but unfortunately they need parts as well. Well, I'm gonna shut up. Cabin air filter done. Get Audrey up on the ramps. Let's get her oil filter off and get her oil changed. She's gasping for new fluids. Surprise! I was not able to put her up on the Rhino ramps. She was too low, so they were hitting here and she was just pushing them along. So I've had to jack her up. Flipping blasted squirrels. Ah. Little buggers. All the Japanese stuff. Sweet. Cheeky little induction kit she's got there. All right. The drain is just here. So I'm gonna pop that off, get this out, and fill her up. Sweet. 17 mil. All right, let's pop that off. I have to take my glasses off. Too flipping sweaty. All right, Oi, 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 oi. That was on tight. Really tight. All right, there we go. Oh, she is dirty. She is dirty. Good job. I'm changing it. Well dirty. Well dirty. Oh, listening to that noise makes me want to pee. Let's have a look at here. Cheeky little teen. Adjustable suspension there. Quality. Okay, up here is the oil filter. See my hand? It's there, which is a bit of a pain in the bum, to be honest, because it's going to trickle all down there. So I'm not going to wait until it's drained as much as it possibly can, because yeah, it's going to make a bit of a mess. I just flipping splashed it all over my arm. You muppet. I'm going to wait until it's stopped, put the plug back in, wipe it all up, and then I'm going to have a go at undoing the oil filter. That's been draining for long enough now. There's only going to be a small amount of residue left in there, so pop the bolt back in. Don't need to do it too tight. There's a crush washer on it. Now I'm going to slide this out. And have a go at getting this jolly oil filter out. You're laughing it. Here we are. It's up over here. Flipping nightmare because I can't grab it properly to get the purchase on it that I need to twist it without being directly underneath it, and all the oil will trickle down here onto my chest. Oh. Okay, let's have a look. Let's see if we can do this. No. Oh. Flipping heck. Man alive. My gosh. Excuse the heavy breathing. Holy, holy jumping, it's moving. It's moving. Whoop, 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 whoop. All right. It's flipping off, my gosh. Into the darkest depths of Audrey. There we go. She's moving. And here it comes. Don't you dare drip on my flipping t-shirt. Come on. Good girl. Almost done. Well, I must confess, I was expecting it to be a lot more difficult. Sweet. Good stuff. Okay, awesome. Oil filter in. Smear a bit of the old oil around. There we go. Good stuff.
and back at it. Oh my gosh, what a flipping mess. That's a really poor design. Oh well. Now to get the oil in here. I'm just using the suggested 5 to 30 and it's high mileage. She's done about 122,000 now. Drink up, little one, drink up. Slithering and slipping all the way through the engine so that I can soon read it on the dipstick. I'm going to drop her down. I didn't mention at the beginning, I apologise. The oil filter is under the driver's side wing on the back of the engine. They're flipping nice wheels. Flipping nice wheels. Okay, time to drop her down. I picked up a really low jack from Costco when they were on special, and it's been very, very useful. Enough waffle from me. Just drop her down, and I'll check the oil again once she's on the floor. Okay, let's check that oil. Just at the bottom there, so need to put quite a bit more in. Drink up, Audrey, drink up. This stuff is good for you. It usually works fine. That spout fits perfectly in the bottle neck. Not this time. Thanks to the wonders of Google, I found out that she takes, the Odyssey RB1 takes 4.2 litres. So she's had that, which means there was an awful lot of oil in there. Just bear with me, we're going to clean this up. You can use kitty litter. I use this stuff. Oh, what a shame. What a shame. I'm very annoyed with myself. Thanks to the wonders of YouTube, you get to see all the mistakes as well as the victories. Okay. What a palaver. Okay. That's sorted. Put the oil cap back on and I'm going to go for a quick little drive in her. Beautiful evening out there, absolutely gorgeous. So, let's get her all sorted. Get the camera set up and off we go. I unfortunately have to wash my hands after that spill. Yeah, right old mess. Gonna run up to the house, wash my hands, grab a cold drink, then we're gonna take Audrey out for a little spin. So come along, I'll see you in a minute. Louis just come to say hello. I have to grab him and take him inside and put him on the front porch because he started staying out at night. And last year, anyone that has been following me for a while would remember I had another boy cat called Charlie. Anyway, last year he stayed out one night and the coyotes got him. So I don't want the same fate to befall this one. And that's the friendly Japanese lady. Absolutely beautiful evening, flipping heck. It's downtown Caledonia, quite a nice little place, not too far from where I live. This is where I come and do my grocery shopping. I've got myself some dinner, some steak, some garlic bread, and I've got some sweet corn at home. It'll be a nice little feast. So just on the right here,
is Caledonia 0.
Yeah, it's quite pretty down here. Fortunately, the GoPro doesn't show it up properly. Little rabbit in the road. Could have had that for dinner. No, I'm only joking.
So I'm just heading back across the Caledonia Bridge. If you're ever out in this area, there's a bakery along here called Jones Bakery. It's been there for, I don't know, 120 years, maybe even longer. And the flipping food that they make in there is absolutely out of this world. Absolutely gorgeous. And it's baked fresh every day. Yeah, Jones Bakery is just here. Awesome food. Oh, here I am. Home again. God, it's a flipping nice evening. She looks really good with her headlamp lenses sorted out, doesn't she? Looks like a different car. Clear-eyed. So time to get these two back in the garage. They're having a bite to eat, and then it's bedtime. Dinner is served. About flipping time too. Gosh, I'm hungry, and gosh, I'm knackered. Some Snyder's sweet corn. Little bit of garlic bread, a couple of small steaks with steak spice on them, and they've been marinated for an hour or so in soy sauce. If you like the content, please make sure to hit the like button. If you enjoyed the content, why not subscribe? It is all free. I appreciate it very much. The next video is going to be on Audrey again, and I'm going to give her a very thorough, deep detail out externally, including paint correction with the buffing pad polishing, and then ceramic coater. There's a lot of people out there that still don't know about ceramic coating and the benefits of it, so, and it's using an English product. Anyway, I'm going to shut up, stuff my face with this, and then hit the hay. I will see you all soon. Toodle pip.